Sunday. I think it seems like we went from winter to spring, back to winter, now we're hot summer. So it's only gonna get hotter, so we're so glad to have you here all at First English this morning, both in person and online as people continue to gather. Hopefully you grabbed a connect sheet. I just wanna lift up a few things in the connect. Our Fun Bunch, which is a group of women who have not met since last year, will have their first meeting tomorrow in this area right here.
Well, let's start. Fun Bunch tomorrow, 11:30 in this spot. We'd love to have you. Welcome if you're online or in person. We'd love to have you here. It's also Pentecost Sunday, which is a wonderful time that says they're the birthday of the church. It's a wonderful time to come together and be the church. Today, third spot activities from 6th through 12th grade. It's virtual game night from 5:30 to 6:30 will be grades 6 through 8th. 6:30 to 7:30 will be 9th through 12th. We really encourage you to come, be part of that. Inside is our announcement for VBS 2021. The theme is Camping, Getting S'more of Jesus. Will be June 7th through the 10th, 9 to 11 a.m. So registration is still open, and we are still looking for kids to be part of that. Right below that, there's two opportunities. If you're feeling like you're not connected or you'd like to get to know some different people in the church, on Friday mornings from 7 to 8 a.m., we have a Bible Brothers and Breakfast. We meet at 5th Street Bagel, Bagels. And we last week had about 10, 11 people. It's a great time to come together. We always discuss the gospel that's going to be preached on that Sunday. And then right next to that, you'll see Word, Wine, and Women. It's another group of women. They're back meeting in person at Cordial Cork. They meet on Wednesdays at 7:30. Either one of those groups, you don't have to commit to every week. You can come when you can come, but they both discuss this gospel for this coming Sunday. You'll see there that Evelyn Sharvin, some of you might know that name. Yesterday, I presided at her private committal in our Calibarium Chapel this week. And then the prayer list is there. We're always praying for our military. And then today is the last Sunday of Sunday school. So today is the last Sunday of Sunday school. We'll dismiss those when it comes time, and we'll do the thank you then. Our fall giving, our May giving tree this month is VBS. We're still collecting things like that. Pastor John is not with us today. Hopefully he's watching online right now. It's his birthday. He turned a certain age, 69. I'll tell you, he turned 69 yesterday. So if you're watching, Pastor John, happy birthday to you. And so he's gone this weekend, but he'll be back Monday. We are so glad to have you here both in person and online. That's truly, truly mean that from your pastors, we love when people are continuing to come back to church. If you're still watching at home, we encourage you to come. We're still keeping social distancing. We're still keeping safe, keeping us safe here. We'd love to have you here as we continue to worship God. This morning it is Pentecost, and we start a little bit different. We're going to start with a thanksgiving, a baptism. So I invite us to please stand. If you're watching at home, all the words will be on the screen. If you're here in person, all of them will be on the screen as well. Alleluia, Christ is risen. Refreshed by the resurrection life we share in Christ, let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. We thank you, risen Christ. We bless you, risen Christ, that your spirit comes to us in the grace-filled waters of rebirth. Breathe your peace on your church when we hide in fear. Cleanse our hearts. To you be given all praise with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God now and forever. Amen. Our opening song this morning is Breathe. As we take that breath in on this Pentecost Sunday, the Pentecost Sunday where the Spirit is the center of the worship, we begin our invocation with this. We worship in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. To all who are spiritually weary and seek rest, to all who struggle and desire victory, to all who are strangers and want fellowship, to all who will come and call upon the name of the Lord, God will remove from us, from our hearts of stone, and put His Holy Spirit in us. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Mighty God, you breathe life into our bones, and your Spirit brings truth to the world. Send us the Spirit, transform us by your truth, and give us language to proclaim your gospel. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. I invite you all to please be seated. At this time, we normally do our children times, our youth time, but today is the last Sunday of Sunday school, so I wanted to, if you're here, I'm going to ask you to stand up, and then we'll recognize you. So Tracy Amix, as always, why don't you come up and tell them what they taught, Katie? She loves this part.
Okay, Tracy Amix and Kathy Buckley led our preschool, kindergarten, first grade group, and Dawn has stepped in to fill in a couple times for us. And then our middle age group has been led by Rochelle Rogan, who usually comes to the later service, Nikki Brock and Alicia Triana, who are both in this service.
Stand up, please. We also, our Sunday school superintendent, Swoopin' Score leaders are Melody Williams, if you please stand up. And Katie Belanja, please stand up, and we can give them a round of applause as well. Sunday school is a part that we continue to believe that's an important part of one's faith journey. So we continue to offer at 9:15. It's been a little bit different through COVID this year, but we thank the teachers that have stepped up and made that happen, and also our directors. So at this time, I encourage anyone that wants to go to Sunday school to head off with Miss Nikki Brock over there, Miss Kathy Wirtenberg back there, and Dawn Sonsini right there. Well, I didn't make Dawn stand up. You should have stood up too, Dawn. Good morning, and so this morning's a little bit different. We only have one reading, and so I'm going to read it this morning. It's Pentecost Sunday. Pentecost Sundays, we know the story from Acts to where all the disciples or apostles are sitting in their room, and the Spirit of the Lord comes upon them, and then we get that long list of different languages they continue to speak, and the devout Jews that were around heard that speaking, and they ran to where they were listening, and they were listening, and the apostles were speaking in the devout Jews' language. But I wanted to hear differently this year. I wanted us to focus on Ezekiel on Pentecost Sunday. So this is the gospel as I see it, the gospel from the book of Ezekiel, which isn't normally, we read the gospels out of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, but the good news can come out of the Old Testament. So hear these words this morning. The hand of the Lord came upon me. Well, this is Ezekiel, so you need to know that part. Ezekiel saying that when it says, the hand of the Lord came upon me, that means like he's having a vision. So all of this is a vision from here on out. The hand of the Lord came upon me, Ezekiel, and he brought me out to the Spirit. He brought me out by the Spirit of the Lord and set me down in the middle of a valley. It was full of bones. He led me all around them. They were very many lying in the valley, and they were very dry. He said to me, mortal, Ezekiel, can these bones live? And he answered, oh, Lord, you know. Then he said to me, prophesy to these bones, and say to them, oh, dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord God to these bones, I will cause breath to enter you, and you shall live. I will lay sinew on you, and you will cause, and will cause flesh to come upon you, and cover you with skin, and put breath in you, and you shall live, and you shall know that I am the Lord. So I prophesied as I had been commanded to, and as I prophesied, suddenly there was a noise, a rattling, and the bones came together, bones to its bones. I looked, and there were sinews on them, and the flesh had come upon them, and the skin had overcome them, have covered them, but there was no breath in them. Then he said to me, God said to Ezekiel, prophesy to the breath, prophesy, mortals, so and say to the breath, Thus says the Lord God, come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon these slain, that they may live. I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived, and stood on their feet, a vast multitude. Then he said to me, mortals, these bones are the whole house of Israel. They say our bones are dried up, and our hope is lost. We are cut off completely. Therefore, prophesy and say to them, thus says the Lord God, I'm going to open your graves and bring you up from the graves, O my people, and I will bring you back to the land of Israel, and you shall know that I am the Lord. When I open your graves and bring you up from the grave, O my people, I will put my spirit within you, and you shall live. And I will place you on your own soil. Then you shall know that I, the Lord, have spoken and will act, says the Lord. The word of the Lord. An amazing reading for us this morning. You might remember that song, them bones, dry bones, them bones, dry bones. The hand bone connected to the wrist bone. A song about this reading, a song about Israel as they're in exile, being called and spoken into and being told by God, you will once again be where you were. Ezekiel given this task by God to go stand among the people of Israel, to go stand among those dry bones and tell them to have hope. Don't give up. Don't give up, and it will be again where you will be back in your land, and I, God, will take care of you. A great word for us today, isn't it? On Pentecost Sunday. Because on Pentecost Sunday is also the birthday of the church. I don't know if everyone knows that. It's the birthday of church because it was that time when the Spirit came upon the apostles and told them, you're going to go proclaim these words. But see, all the apostles were Galileans. But they started to speak in different languages. So it says the devout Jews could understand them. So it's the birthday of the church because from there they went home and shared the good news. So happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear church. Happy birthday to you. Not First English Lutheran Church, but the church as a whole. And we all know birthdays are exciting. They're exciting times in our lives. And maybe if we're getting a little bit older, we don't always get excited because it's another number that getting older. But if we really think about it, they are exciting. There are times that we get to come together with family and friends and we laugh and we share stories. I love the excitement when we all gather around, we turn off the lights and we sing that song, Happy Birthday to You. And yes, I love what comes after the singing. Does anyone know what that is? The cake! The cake, because I always get that wonderful piece of cake. Today is the birthday of the church. Because not because I decided, because it is Pentecost, as I said, and the Acts reading tells us how that spread it out. I don't know about you, but we need a celebration these days. We need to celebrate the birthday because if we're honest, it's been a crazy and unique year since our last Pentecost in the church. But it's also been a unique and crazy year for the world that we live in. If you are like me, we look forward to the next year. We look forward to the next year as a church and in our lives. We look forward to where we have come and look to where the Spirit of God is leading us as we move into this new life we live. So this Pentecost is a special one. It's a birthday for the church, but maybe it's also a rebirth for the church. After a year with many things in the world, including the church, was shut down. So we celebrate this birthday like no other. We maybe celebrate it like the first apostles on the first Pentecost. They gathered just like we did and they heard the Holy Spirit and they began to speak in different languages. And not just any languages, as I said, the ones that the devout Jews could hear, the ones that people outside the church could hear.
Yes, it's the birthday of the church. But also maybe it's a birthday for all of us today too. Because maybe we need to hear the gospel a little bit different today. You remember last week, if you were here, if you watched online, you were able to see our confirmand stand up here and give their faith talk. At the root of all of them, they would say really this kind of some of the same things where God was present to them. They felt God's power and love. They confessed their faith to all of you. Did that inspire you to go home and think about it yourself? Where I grew up, Pentecost was always the day of confirmation. So it always reminds me when we get close to them that that's something that I have to always think about too is, God, why do I want to recommit or how am I going to? So I'm deciding that this Pentecost, this birthday of the church, gives all of you here in person and online permission to look at your own lives, to look at your own spiritual lives, to look at your faith lives, to look at your relationship with God. And yes, your relationship with the church. Not the building church, but the church of the people. And I first tell you to celebrate it. Because you're here. You're watching. Truly celebrate it. But let us stop also and see how it's doing. How are we connecting with God and the community God has placed us in? How are we connecting with others who need to hear the word of God as well and with other parts of our lives? And how are we listening to the Spirit and allowing the Holy Spirit to move us into this next year? But let's not also forget the connection part of Pentecost. I've said it many times that they spoke in those people's native languages so that they could hear the gospel. We've gone over a year now where being connected with people isn't really been encouraged. We use technology, but connection through technology just isn't the same. People desire to be in community, to be in fellowship with each other, and not through a screen in the same room. And if we're honest, the church, all of us, the worldly church, needs to be in person as well. This has nothing to do with people that can't come right now, that don't feel safe at home. It's not a plea to get you to come back. It's a plea because if I would talk to you, you would say the same thing. It's just not the same. This is Pentecost Sunday. Pentecost this year is a little bit different than last year because we are starting to see hope on the horizon. We're starting to see hope on the horizon, and that takes us to our reading for today. Our reading for today where Ezekiel stands in the midst of them. When Ezekiel stands in the midst of those bones and tells them to breathe. A story for you. So back my senior year in high school, many of you know I played hockey, so we're in the third period of the hockey game playing the last game of the season against our rivals, the St. John's Jesuits. They were the only other male Catholic school in Toledo. And I was playing for St. Francis, and it was my senior year, and it would be the last time that I had a chance to beat that other team. We know how those rivalries work, right? We played them one other time at the beginning of the season, and I'm pretty sure I remember beating them at least by double digits. I mean, we were a dominant team, but this was the last regular season before going to the postseason. We were undefeated in the regular season. A perfect season was at our hand. All we had to do was win. As I stated earlier, we were in the locker room waiting between periods, and it was the third period, the last 15 minutes of the game, and we were down by five. Five goals. And so we were in there, and I remember being it just so quiet. We all just sat there and looked at each other. I'm guessing we were just all a little shocked because we truly just destroyed this team a couple weeks earlier. And then we were seeing, then all of a sudden, the coach walks in. And most of you think he probably came in and yelled and screamed, but he didn't. He grabbed a chair, walked right in, and grabbed a chair and sat in the middle of the room. And I still remember him just sitting there, and we're all thinking, oh, man, we're in trouble. And he simply said, are we ready to win? Are we ready to win? And he sat there, and we're all thinking, well, of course we are. But he continued to go on from there, and his words never got loud. He never screamed. He never got mad, which he did plenty other times. But as he spoke, you could feel the energy in the room rise. You could feel that no longer were we individuals, we became a team again.
As he spoke, the excitement entered back into the room and we started to come together. As he spoke, we began to move around again and life came back into that locker room. And believe it or not, that life went out onto the ice. And we beat those Johnnies by 3 points that last period. Just telling that story still brings excitement to me. I and probably many of you have had that kind of situation where someone has spoken words to you. Someone has spoken words into your soul and you left excited. I remember working at Sam's Club and the same kind of thing where every morning we'd have to go there and they'd do this cheer just to get us excited for the day. And it worked. I'm guessing most of you here today have had an experience in your own life when you had maybe had someone speak into you. Maybe it was at work. Maybe it was at a locker room. Maybe it was in a classroom. Maybe it was simply a friend calling and giving you time on the phone. Maybe it was a text message. Maybe it was a wave. We've all had some time in our lives when someone has spoken words to us that brought us through a hard time in life or brought us back to life. That is exactly where Ezekiel finds himself this morning in our reading. He's given a vision by God, as I said, where he's to prophesy or speak into these dead bones that are laying there, scattered around the valley. He is given the vision of sitting there in the middle, and God says to him, Ezekiel, can these bones live? Sort of like when the coach walked in and said, are you ready to win? But I love Ezekiel's answer. He says, oh Lord, you know. Then what God tells him to do is to prophesy. Prophesy to these bones. You know the rest of the story. He does as he's commanded, and by the end of the vision, the bones are connected and are filled with breath and stand on their feet. What a great story. What a great story for us as we look at how the world's going to be and how we are called to go out and to prophesy when the area that we're called to live in. What a great story where Ezekiel's actually probably the first true coach in the locker room that finds his team to be hopeless. He's a parent who found their child lost or confused about the world, and he or she is called to speak hope into their lives. He's the teacher that continues to bring hope into a classroom day after day when they see that students are tired or dried up. He's the business owner who put on a positive face and lifts up the company after a hard year. He's the spouse that simply hugs their husband, wife, after a long day, week, or year. He is the one, when all seems lost, hopeless, over, he comes along and speaks into that. And not just anything, he speaks the word of God. He speaks the word of the Lord. He speaks into the promises of God, and they come alive. Brothers and sisters, I probably most find it's easy to be the Ezekiel in the text, but I wonder how often we are the dry bones. We are the ones laying in the desert thirsty for connection, thirsty for living, thirsty for the Spirit. And maybe you find yourself there this morning, either here in person or online. Because let's be honest, this last year has been hard. Especially if you're an extroverted person that gets energy from other people, it's been a hard year. And I'm not really sure what you bring with you this morning, and maybe you're fine this morning, but maybe next week or the month after or the year later, what concerns are you bringing with you in worship this morning will be different. But I need you to hear these words this morning, both in person and online. You are loved. You are loved by an amazing God. You are amazing because God created you. You are amazing because God created you. You are special because God knows everything about you, every little piece of hair on your body. And lastly, you are a child of God. You are a child of God. So whatever it is that you're going through today, tomorrow, remember those four things. They're not just words to brush off. They are words that I've had to tell myself over the years, and they are words that I've had to tell many other people over the years. They're words that we can count on.
They're the words that, not the exact words, but the same things that Ezekiel said to those bones. I am with you. I will protect you, Israel. I will bring you back. They are the words that have continued to speak into the world that we live in today, as Ezekiel did to those bones many years ago. So this is Pentecost Sunday, a birthday Sunday, a time to evaluate our faith and wonder where we're at. But when we do that, I need you to hear, you are loved. You are amazing. You are special. You are a child of God. Hear those words and allow the Spirit to move you and to move inside you. And that, brothers and sisters, is, guess what? The good news for us today. Amen. I invite us to stand and sing. You'll notice that our song is about breath and wind this morning, because that is the other word for the Spirit. So as we continue to sing those songs, let us please stand. Let us pray.
Before we get to those prayers, let us just pray. Good and gracious God, we come, and we do. We do. We want to know you. That's why we're here, both in person and online. And if we're searching and we know other people that are searching, maybe we need to be called out and to be speak words into those people. So not as judgmental words, but words that we know that we're alive and we want them to walk with us. So give us that courage to do that as we leave here. And maybe one of us here need to hear that as well. I know, God, that I have, and there's got to be other that need to hear, continue, that we are loved by you. No matter what. No matter what. That's good news. That's what the Spirit needs us to believe. So let us open our hearts as we enter into prayer this morning. Trusting the Spirit's power, we pray for the church, the world, and all the God's creation. For the church as it receives your Holy Spirit and shares its hope in Christ. For advocates of truth and forgiveness and for perseverance in prayer, hear us, O God. For the creation as life takes root and grows. For the earth and all the planets, for the sun, moon, and stars, for the natural wonders in, among, and beyond us, hear us, O God. For the nations as they seek guidance. For the nations as they seek guidance. For government and tribal leaders. For international organizations. For translators, interpreters. For prophets and peacemakers. Hear us, O God. For those who suffer as they are long for healing. For those who are lonely or forgotten. For those who are ill or grieving. For those who deal with depression and sadness. Hear us, O God. For our church. For First English Lutheran Church. In the midst of new days of ministry and service. In the midst of changing times and transitions, in the midst of ministries and outreaches, and in the midst of serving a God who is always unchanging in love and grace, hear us, O God. Receive these prayers, gracious God, and those prayers known only to you. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We pray together the prayer that Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us share the sign of peace as we've become accustomed to or as you are comfortable with. Peace be with you. With you if you're watching online. Continue on with our offering prayer. Blessed are you, O God, ruler of heaven and earth. Day by day, you shower us with blessings. As you have raised us to new life in Christ, give us glad and generous hearts, ready to praise you and to respond to those in need, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Our benediction today is the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. I invite forward our praise team to come forward. And as I'm doing that, I would also always remind us and be gracious to the wonderful gifts that you all share with our church as well. So if we could let them know that before we do it at the end too. Build your kingdom here.
Again, increase in us. See you.